Do I have adrenal fatigue because of my genetics? I'm Dr. Carrie Lam. This is Dr. Michael Lam. We're here to talk about whether adrenal fatigue syndrome can be passed down from your parents, from your grandparents. What do you think?
Well, what we see is that, first of all, no one is born with perfect genes. We all have certain defects, okay? And research has shown that a good 70% of our eventual exposure to a disease, etc., is caused and modulated by lifestyle and our diet and what we do to ourselves.
That's called epigenetics.
Correct. While 30% is, you know, pure genetic play. Of course, we are now not, we're talking about normal people, not the people in extremes that are born with severe genetic defects. That's a different situation. Mm-hmm. But most people who are born normal, they go through normal life, you know, they have to be able to expect that all of us, our genes are not perfect. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, more genetic testing nowadays are able to come up and teach us. For example, now we can test for methylation issues, you know, and like the MTHFR. And so we can spot genetic defects much, much earlier today. But the big picture is that, you know, it's still much of it is a lifestyle and a diet driven and nutritional.
Right, through a little cheek swab, you're gonna able to see where your ancestry is from, what genetic mutations you've had, because everyone has the same DNA genome. It's just what has been turned on or turned off or been mutated. That's what makes every person different.
Yeah, and what we go through to our body, you mentioned the epigenetics, is so critical. And it's, you know, research is saying this is actually more and more critical, because what we do to our daily life, whether it's smoking, stressful, whether we're the adrenaline junkie, eventually it does affect our genes, because our genes also can modulate over time.
Mm. So do you think that it is genetic? Like, oh, my mom has it, so I'm going to have it.
Well, I think there's definitely a correlation. What we do see is a weak mother, for example, will tend to give birth to weak children. And studies have already shown that, for example, a pregnant woman that has a hypothyroid have a tendency to give rise to kids that are more hypothyroid than normal. And you can actually see with ultrasound in utero, you know, they already have the missing eyebrows, for example, in the later gestational stages. So, you know, more and more so, this is actually makes sense, right? Because if you're strong, you're going to give rise to strong kids. If you're a weak mother, you're going to give rise to, this is just physiological, logical. Mm. But the question is, well, how do you detect and when does it show up? And this is something that nobody knows at this point. Some people, it never shows up because they're strong enough. For some people, you may have very strong grandparents and you can be weak.
Right.
Or you can be very weak and you have your strong, your parents may be weak as well. So I think the genetic component is there. We don't have the hard evidence to say to what degree at this particular time, because we're dealing with adrenal issues that is kind of in the gray zone where you feel weak, but your adrenals actually are pathologically okay.
Right, you mean you can cut it open and they don't find anything wrong with it.
Correct. Mm-hmm. But genetics, I think that the lesson you have to learn is that it pays for you to have good lifestyle and nutrition. That way, at least you prevent the undesirable epigenetic plays to come in.
So lifestyle modifications play a big part in affecting your genes. Mm-hmm. So the way you live your life, making it less stressful, will be able to play positively in the way you express your genes.
Yeah, and you talk about expression is very important, because just because you have a genetic link does not mean that you fall apart, you see what I'm saying? And even if you fall apart because of the expression, there are ways you can do to allow the body to self-heal, because the body has a built-in system to do that, you see? So the mechanisms are already there. So it's not like it's 100% loss. This is totally extreme.
So that's a wrap up of how genetics might play into a part in adrenal fatigue. And we hope that you enjoyed this video. And we're here to empower you on your health journey towards recovery.